Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn figures of speech. Figures of speech are the poetic devices or they are literary devices. So today we are going to learn alliteration. So today we will learn about alliteration. Now, what is alliteration? Alliteration is the figure of speech used when the beginning consonant sound is repeated between two or more words in a phrase or sentence. That is called as alliteration. So let us have a look at some examples of alliteration. Now see on the board, when I do count the clock, so you can see that here the sound count and clock, k sound is repeated. So it is an example of alliteration. Next, come and clean the chaos in your closet. Come clean closet. K sound is repeated again. Next, the fair breeze blew. Breeze blew. B sound is repeated. The white foam flew. Foam flew. F sound is repeated. Into the silent sea. S sound is repeated. Now you have seen cheerful cock. Now this is not an example of alliteration. Why? Because even though the beginning word is C, but it has a different sound. Cheerful, ch sound, and cock, k sound is there. So this is not an example of alliteration. So alliteration means the same sound, the same initial sound is repeated in a phrase or sentence, then it is called alliteration. So let us look at the examples of alliteration in your poem Her Head. In your second stanza, fourth line, the cattle kraals are empty. The cattle kraals are empty. Now here the sound k, even the alphabet is different, but it produces the same sound. It produces k sound, cattle and kraal. So this is an example of alliteration. Next, same stanza, fifth line, the goats gaunt. The goats gaunt. G sound. So this is an example of alliteration. Next, third stanza, first line, the engineers have reversed the river. The engineers have reversed the river. R sound, R sound is repeated. So it is an example of alliteration. So I hope you have understood what is alliteration. Now let us go to the next figure of speech, that is imagery. Imagery is a figure of speech in which the words appeal to the physical sense. We imagine those images. For example, the candy melted in her mouth. So you can imagine the candy melting in the mouth, isn't it? It can appeal your senses. So this is an example of imagery. Next, it was dark and dim in the forest. So you can imagine dark and dim, right? Next, the children are screaming and shouting. So you can imagine the screaming and shouting sound of children. Then the fresh and juicy orange is very cold and sweet. Juicy, cold, sweet. You can imagine these senses, right? So these are all imagery. So the lines which create images in front of the reader, which appeals to the senses of the reader, they are called as imagery. The example in your poem is from the first stanza, fifth line, when one child in three is at risk of death. So you can imagine this scene in front of your eyes. One child in three is at the risk of death. So this is an example of imagery. The third figure of speech is transport epithet. Now what is transport epithet? Transport epithet is a figure of speech in which a modifier, that is usually an adjective, qualifies a noun rather than a person or thing it describes. It means that an adjective qualifies another noun. It means that a modifier is transferred from a noun it is meant to describe to another noun in the sentence. Okay, or you can say that the modifier or an adjective is transferred from a noun to which it belongs. It is transferred from a noun to which it belongs to another noun in the sentence with which it fits only grammatically, not logically or practically. Practically, it doesn't fit the noun which it describes, but it is meant to describe another noun, but it is used with some other noun in that sentence. You will understand with the help of example. So let us see some examples. I had a wonderful day. Now here, wonderful is an adjective which describes the noun day. But can the day be wonderful? No, it is the experience. I experienced this wonderful day. So it is the experience, my experience. So the adjective is transferred from I to day. So it is called as transport epithet. Another example, cruel bars. Can the bars be cruel? No. It is the person who is cruel, who has made those bars, who has made that cage. So that person is cruel. So the adjective cruel is for the person, but it is transferred to bars. Next, sleepless night. Does the night have any emotions? No. So how the night can be sleepless? Can it be sleepless? No. It is the person who is not able to sleep at night. So we can say that I spent a sleepless night. So here also an adjective is transferred from the person to the noun night. Right? Same way, unhappy marriage. Marriage can't be unhappy. The unhappy are those two people or the couple who is not doing well in their marriage, right? Then dreamless night. Night can't be dreamless. It is the person who doesn't have any dream that night. So again here the noun is transferred. So when a noun is transferred from a noun to which it is meant to another noun where it fits grammatically, then that is called as transferred epithet. Now in your book, in the poem or head, the example of transferred epithet is dusty crowds. Dusty crowds. Crowds cannot be dusty, right? So this is an example of transferred epithet in the poem Her Head. I hope you have understood alliteration, imagery, and transferred epithet. Thank you.